Please let me do this interview.
CY, Spence or Crawford?
It's Spence.
Spence or Crawford?
I'm going for Crawford. Having a chance to box
him. Why Spence? Why Spence?
Not Crawford.
Why Spence?
Okay, Spence, he overwhelmed his opponent with a lot of punches. I don't think Crawford could take that much pressure. Look, Crawford's a great fighter, but I also seen Gamboa hurt him. He's been hurt a few times, so I think Spence will get him in the long run. Probably like the 10th round.
Okay, he says Spence by stoppage. What do you say?
No, I go Crawford because he can switch and he'll change the claim and make adjustments. All you gotta do is stay away from the tools. It's a southpaw, he can switch.
You just gotta catch him, that's it.
But he got to stay away from the punches. See, Spence throw a lot of punches. Ugas learned that. Brooks learned that. And everybody that Spence fought, all who grown broke. A lot of people. Two, three people.
Okay, why don't all these experts put Gervonta Davis on a pound-for-pound list? He's definitely one of the best pound-for-pound fighters.
Why? Because he's definitely the top, so he should be.
Same thing with Jermell Charlo. I don't see him on anyone's pound-for-pound opponents except mine. He's the king of 154.
Look, Jermell Charlo is a lion.
Why are they hating on him?
I don't know. Look, it's always politics of boxing, but maybe he need to come down or go up and fight somebody.
He runs a division. You want to fight in that division, you have to fight him.
See, look, let me tell you, no one make fighters great challenging yourself. Look. Zab challenges himself. Roy challenges himself. Went up divisions. Canelo challenged himself. Gervonta challenged himself. They went up. That's what made him great. Charlo stayed in one division. That's why they probably saying he's not pound for pound.
Who do you want to see David Benavidez fight next?
I want him to fight Charlo.
Who wins?
Benavidez.
Benavidez or Charlo?
I think Benavidez wins by.
I got Benavidez because his work rate, and he hit hard, and they ducking him for a reason.
Okay, Swaggy P against Blueface.
I'm going with Blueface.
I don't know.
What you say?
Nick Young, who played for the Lakers, against Blueface, the rapper.
I got Blueface.
Everybody here got Blueface. It's July 30th at Staples Center. Okay, last one. Ryan Garcia, July 16th, Javier Fortuna.
I love Ryan. I'm a Ryan fan, you know. Fortuna can't beat him. Ryan is one of the top in 35, so that's what I agree. Hey, what's up? I agree with that.
What about Chop Chop Corley if he fights Zab?
You know, look, the redemption won't happen because Chop Chop a legend.
And look, Chop Chop still
look,
fighting.
I
didn't recognize without the hair now. You have a new afro.
Chop Chop. I ain't got my wig on today.
Chop Chop's son in DC. I train. That's where I train out.
Are you in the hall? He had like 20 kids. Which one?
Oldest.
11 or 12?
His oldest son.
11.
11. Chop Chop, how's it to be a dad of 11 kids?
It's amazing.
It's a lot of work. I know. I'm saying it's a lot of work. One kid's a lot of work.
No. You gotta have patience.
Give me golf.
Any of them box?
Yeah, two of them.
A professional?
The 21-year-old's pro, and then the 9-year-old still amateur.
Who's he fight like? Does he fight like his dad? Or
the 9-year-old dude.
Southpaw too?
That's over 5'10", got long arms. 40-pounder.
I just came back from the Hall of Fame. So when are you getting into the Hall of Fame? You're still active.
Retired.
Which is not going to happen because every week he calls me. He's like, hey, I want to fight. And he's ready. He's in shape.
With Ryan Garcia.
Well, yeah, you Southpaw.
Yeah.
Okay. What did you, out of Miguel Cotto, you fought him.
Yeah.
Floyd Mayweather, you fought him. Yeah, who else was there that got inducted that you fought?
Zab.
What, is Zab in the Hall of Fame yet?
Yeah, he's in.
The big one?
Not the big one, no, but yeah.
He Hall of Fame. Going.
Yeah, he will be, of course. Five-time champ, undisputed, 47.
Six times.
Okay.
Madonna's going, eventually.
You beat him, actually.
Yeah.
He beat Chino Maidana.
Huh?
He beat Marcos Maidana.
Well, I know.
So who would you want to fight right now? If they called you and said, line up three opponents.
I got to look at the list at 135.
Okay.
Ready?
Devin Haney and you, do you like it?
Nah.
Why not? Zab.
My God.
Him and Devin Haney, what do you think?
No.
He's still fighting. He wants to fight the best.
Not Devin. Chop Chop. No.
I don't want that smoke.
How about him and Rolly? Is that a good fight?
Yeah.
You'll fight Rolly
with Chop Chop.
No.
Yeah.
Why not?
I don't want my legend getting in there with one. No.
He thinks Rolly's gonna flatten you out.
No.
That's what he's saying.
Tank just flattened him out.
Oh, you think Rolly? No. I'm not saying that. I just don't want. I don't want to see that.
Okay, so who do you want him fight? He's still fighting. Him and Lomachenko, would you like that fight? He sparred Loma?
I like that fight.
What do you think? Fight? Him and Loma.
I can see that fight. Because you crafty. Him and Loma.
That'd be a good fight.
Because there's no danger with Tank and Rolly. They hit too hard.
No, look, he's not worried about that.
I can get Rolly. Tank is a problem, though.
Why do you say that?
He's a tank. That young joker coming.
But Rolly hits hard, too, no?
Rolly's awkward. And he get caught with
so,
that.
Like, Chino was awkward.
Yeah.
Right. Look, I ain't gonna lie. Rolly's one of my favorite fighters.
He's a great dude, great fighter. Yep.
He's willing to go on the sword and he throw everything with, like, bad intention.
Did you have a spar tank?
Nope, not yet.
Okay.
I'm waiting.
But you've seen him spar. I've seen you at the gym.
Yeah.
Who have you sparred? I wanted to ask you that. Who have you sparred legendary that you looked up to before your career?
I got a chance to work with Shane Mosley for the Pacquiao fight.
Okay. Shout out to Shane, one of the nicest people in boxing.
He went into the Hall of Fame.
Yeah? He could hit very hard, too.
If he's sitting there and bang with you, but Shane, he didn't want to exchange.
What was your best asset in your fight game that you used? Learning from the veterans, the Bettons, Painters, Sean Bay Mitchell, Mark Two Shot Johnson, Two Shot, another South Paul, Prenel Whitaker, Sugar Ray Lennon. I mean, I learned a lot from those old fighters. Teddy can punch.
Right.
I've been doing this
forever, man.
It ain't gonna stop.
Shout to make it.
Look, I'm telling you, watch. Next prospect.
It won't stop until we at the top.
Reporting. Yo, I promise you, tap into my brother, man.
Thank you. The top. I always tell people, if I was a fighter, I'd want to be a champion, right?
Right.
So if I do this, I want to be the best. These are the Judah twins?
Right.
Or, they got big. Who's the champion here in boxing? You better than all of them? You guys box?
Show them your signature move. What you showing me? Can you show them your
Wow. Two uppercuts? And an over.
Go ahead, Papa.
Who's your guys' favorite fighter?
My dad.
Double trouble in the head.
Right.
What's your favorite fighter, your dad? Which of your dad's fight, because he won a lot of them, which is your favorite? Which one have you watched many times?
Spence.
He didn't fight Spence.
It was Spinks.
Oh, Spinks. Do you have any favorite fights? No, but you want to be champions like your dad?
Yeah.
He was the last one to have all the belts at 147.
Wait, who is that?
Undisputed.
Is that famous?
Yeah.
One of the best fighters in the history of boxing, Zab Judah.
He was right there.
Yeah, he's very famous. His pictures are on the wall with Jay-Z, with Mike Tyson, with Muhammad Ali, with everybody. Yeah, it's your dad. Where's he at? Oh, there's Lil Zal over there. That's Justin Bieber's best friend right here coming. He's boxing tomorrow night. No. I thought that was Tim Bradley here, but
that's the one.
Oh, there's your dad. Oh, that. Layla V.
Yeah.
You're fighting tomorrow. Tell us about your fight. Who are you fighting?
I'm fighting Asia Eros. I'm Layla V. We're gonna get it in tomorrow. We got the notice on Monday.
Short notice, obviously.
Short notice. You get what I'm saying? So I know this is different from street fighting. So I'm gonna go out there and give it my all. And my new single, Lit Like Ages, dropped, and my music video's coming out. So you know. We out here, I'm International Battle Station, but I'm finna show y'all what I can do.
Okay, who's your favorite fighter all time?
See, I don't watch a lot of people, right? But the people that I see, I really like Layla Ali, and I really like Clarissa.
Shields, shout out to her, the quote.
Man, she's
okay, if you had to walk her out with a song, what song are you going with?
Walk who out?
Clarissa for her next fight.
I'm walking her out to my single, 90s Kid.
Give us a little sample.
Okay. back in the days of the 90s, kids. See, I'm a cool kid on the beat. I got them J's on my feet. I'ma kick it like karate on my first Spike Lee's. Huh. Oh, shit, I forgot my own song, but it's okay.
It's good. We can look it up. Okay.
I've been singing it for 10 years, so.
If you could, last thing, if you could collaborate with any other artists, who are you working with? Who would you collaborate with?
As far as like the whole industry? Okay, if I could collaborate with anybody, I would say, of course, Chris Brown. Let's get it. You get what I'm saying? I'm original crump dancer. Why not? You feel me? With the arm brain.
How did you do that?
I mean, it's magic. That's what I do. I get paid to do that on stage.
Tell people where to follow you.
Hey, you guys follow me at Layla V Land. That's LailaV Land, LAND. You already know.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Good luck tomorrow. They're fighting. Oh, that's your opponent. Maybe we could get a face off.
Yeah, you want me to go?
You want a picture or you want me to keep recording?
Take a picture.
All right, coming to you live right now.
Wait, give me a picture first.